For us, one of the turning points in being able to improve quality of care in our practice was starting to hear directly from patients and working with them to come up with solutions to make things better.
We should not underestimate the power of four things: commitment, curiosity, quality improvement, and research.
Data is really important to help us know what we're doing well and what we're not doing well.
On est tous habitués à travailler dans les silos. On est tous habitués à travailler dans notre ligne de profession. Et l'amélioration continue réunit un peu tous les joueurs importants qu'on ne connaît pas souvent. On travaille dans une clinique médicale ou dans un hôpital. Puis on essaie vraiment de regarder le problème de tous les côtés et de trouver les solutions qui vont être vraiment bien comprises, mais aussi bien utilisées, bien implantées au sein des équipes.
Trust us as the patients. No one uses healthcare for fun. I would love to see the conversation switch from what's the matter with you to what matters to you.
Quality improvement, or QI, can be done in any practice setting. It can be inspired by the work we do every day. The ideas and leadership for QI can come from any team member, and we don't have to wait for others to tell us what improvement needs to be done.
Many practices engage in QI because it's something that they've been told to do. It's part of what government wants. But I have to say, in my own personal experience, if that's the motivation, it's just not going to go where we need it to go. I find QI works so much better when it's coming intrinsically, when the motivation is intrinsic.
Secondly, QI also helps us to look at how we can improve our own work conditions, reigniting the passions for healthcare work and making health workers more resilient. In this video, we will explore how everyone benefits from quality improvement and how we can support QI in our own workplaces.
What we want as patients and families are a proper diagnosis and good advice and reassurance on how to manage the symptoms or our chronic conditions. We want that reassurance that you are in our shared space of worry, knowing that you as my doctor care.
Many family doctors are engaged in quality improvement and have been doing it for a long time, but they may not refer to their efforts as quality improvement. For example, assessing practice changes that enhance access to care, or doing a medical record audit to evaluate patient health outcomes. They're common types of quality improvement activity.
Un très bel exemple de l'amélioration continue en milieu clinique, c'est l'implantation des dossiers médicaux électroniques dans les cliniques de première ligne. Donc, ça a été un processus d'amélioration quand même assez complexe et d'un côté un peu imposé par le besoin et puis par le mouvement de masse.
So in our own practice, we came up with sort of a dashboard of quality measures that we now track on a routine basis. Some of those measures come from patient experience surveys, some of it comes from the EMR, some of it comes from provincial reports that we get, and some of it actually comes from manual audit. And we take the initiative to kind of pull all those data sources together to try and get a comprehensive picture of how we're doing. And then we don't try and improve every single area, but rather we look at how we're doing and then we kind of prioritize which are the areas that we really need to focus on.
La médecine de famille étant une discipline qui demande de la curiosité et de l'humilité, nous nous demandons constamment ce que nous faisons bien et ce que nous pourrions mieux faire. L'amélioration continue de la qualité peut nous aider à mettre le doigt sur ces points à améliorer et nous permettre d'évaluer les changements que nous faisons pour combler ces lacunes. Malheureusement, on se dit trop souvent qu'on n'a pas le temps de s'arrêter pendant quelques minutes pour réfléchir à notre travail, même quand on sait qu'il serait possible de mieux faire certaines choses pour nos patients ou pour simplifier nos tâches.
In 2018, the CFPC's section of residents surveyed family medicine residents across the country about their views of quality improvement. Close to three-quarters of the residents who responded to the survey said QI is important or very important in their future practices.
Residents in our family practice training programs really need to do quality improvement. And we introduced a quality improvement project for both first and second year residents in our program. And they now are going out into community practices and doing excellent work. And this helps improve the community doctor's practice and develop skills at all levels.
The residents summarize their key reasons for making QI part of their everyday work by saying, it's the right thing to do, it can improve patient care and their own lives. And increasingly, regulatory bodies require physicians to demonstrate ongoing quality improvement activities as part of their professional practice. Not all QI involves large-scale projects. Rather, every family physician can participate in QI activities that are specific to their practice and require fewer resources.
So PDSA cycles can be very brief. They don't need to be lengthy and onerous in the family practice setting. And we often think they have to be, and then that hinders us doing good quality improvement. For example, looking at a video, we had to video our patients, and we developed a script to introduce this to patients, tested it, then evaluated it and revised it again. We did about three of these cycles before we were happy. So it is a team process that can go really quick.
L'amélioration de la pratique est un travail d'équipe qui englobe tout un éventail d'activités, décrites d'ailleurs dans les ateliers du collège intitulés Les essentiels de l'amélioration de la pratique. Il peut s'agir de petites initiatives entreprises individuellement par un médecin ou une clinique, des initiatives de moyenne envergure qui requièrent de simples outils d'amélioration continue de la qualité, ou encore des initiatives à grande échelle qui touchent tout le système.
We started to do something called Doing Better Rounds. So these were rounds specifically focused on patient safety incidents. They were a safe place for people to come together to talk about something that may not have gone well, or something that, you know, maybe went okay in the end, but there was a problem and it could have gone really badly. And so the team can come together and talk about that in a way where it's not about shame and blame, but really about learning and diving into understanding what some of the root factors were that could be changed to prevent that kind of thing from happening again. So using simple tools like a cause and effect diagram to try and get at the root of the problem and then brainstorm solutions for that.
Alors, comment trouve-t-on des améliorations possibles? Nous n'avons qu'à regarder autour de nous. Elles se cachent parfois sous les petits irritants qu'on souhaite éliminer dans nos cliniques ou sous une directive de pratique clinique qui propose une nouvelle méthode qu'on aimerait essayer.
Donc, c'est important de se baser sur les changements qu'on veut apporter, sur quelque chose qui est faisable, quelque chose qu'on voit qui a un intérêt au niveau de l'équipe et quelque chose qu'on voit que va possiblement réussir. Donc c'est important de commencer avec ça dans les équipes où on sait qu'il y a un stress au niveau du travail, de la quantité de, peut-être parce qu'il manque du personnel, peut-être parce qu'il y a beaucoup de patients très malades. Mais c'est important de commencer avec quelque chose qui va motiver les gens, qui va porter fruit et qui va motiver les équipes à s'attaquer à des projets un peu plus complexes.
Here are some stories from colleagues across the country who have identified areas for improvement and used QI approaches to respond to them.
We used a method called experience-based co-design and used it to try and understand our patients' perspective around how they accessed the after-hours care, what they thought about our services, and how they thought we could improve. We worked with them and put kind of their suggestions into practice, and we saw a really dramatic improvements.
We found that we were not adequately screening our patients for hypertension. I think only about half of them were being screened, compared to other practices that were having near 100%. So we got together and looked at what are we doing differently, and what we figured out was the physicians are doing the screens and we're not good at that. So we had our staff who bring patients into the room routinely screen patients coming in. And our next Sipson report, we were at 100% screening.
We engaged the entire team, our nurse, our front staff. We looked for all patients with diabetes who were overdue for weight and blood pressure, and we emailed them and called them to ask them to do this at home using validated home blood pressure machines and their own scale. Within 2 months, 52% of patients had a weight and a blood pressure, and they called or emailed our office to report this. To me, this is better care.
Dans ma clinique à moi, notre équipe, on voulait améliorer certains processus au niveau de la clinique sans rendez-vous pour offrir un meilleur service à notre clientèle parce qu'on recevait beaucoup de plaintes de la part de nos patients, de comment c'était organisé, qu'il y avait beaucoup d'attentes, qu'il y avait une période durant la journée où on prenait pas de patients. Ce que j'ai vécu un peu en participant à cette expérience-là, c'était l'importance de penser à tout le monde qui est impliqué dans des processus comme ça.
We sent out a call to, you know, 10,000 of our patients by email, by postering it on our waiting rooms, and we asked them to volunteer on a Saturday in February to spend the day with us and tell us how our clinic could improve. So we sent it out to 10,000 patients, and we were blown away when 350 responded saying, yeah, I want to come on a Saturday in February and help you guys improve. So from that, we actually randomly selected 36 patients that roughly fit the demographics of the patient population we served. And we worked with them that day to have conversations, first to educate them about kind of the services we provide and what the roles of the providers are and our accountabilities and some of the challenges that we face. And then we heard from them, like what were some of the pain points? And they told us some things that we weren't really aware of and other things that we really were. And they gave us some really practical suggestions for how we could improve.
Together, they helped to realize the quadruple aim, and that is to enhance how patients experience care, to improve the experience of health workers as well, to make the most efficient use of healthcare dollars, and ultimately, to improve the health of entire populations.
What are we doing and how can we be doing it better? And quality improvement and research gives us the tools and the ways of thinking, of approaching it, so that we can find those answers, so we can identify the areas for improvement, and then have the tools to be able then to undertake that, to understand and explore more. And then from that, to inform how we can better provide care, how we can improve efficiencies in the healthcare system, how we can improve safety and quality, and also importantly, how we can improve the experience, not only of patients, but also of ourselves as healthcare providers.
The combination of research and QI has led to the development of what we call practice-based learning networks, or PBLNs. PBLNs bring family physicians and primary care colleagues, such as nurses and pharmacists, together as QI champions. Depending on the questions or challenge at hand, these champions collaborate as a learning and change management team using research methods and QI processes to enhance healthcare.
Everyone benefits from quality improvement. When you look at the quadruple aim, you know, our patients' care is better, our workplace is even better. So quality improvement can start with individual practices, but then we become aware of things that need to be changed at a system level.
Physicians have uniformly really enjoyed the process of peer coaching, and we've seen that it also helps them to actually come up with concrete actions and ultimately, hopefully, improve practice.
Il faut vraiment s'assurer que les projets d'amélioration continue vont bien s'aligner avec c'est quoi la capacité locale, c'est quoi les intérêts, c'est quoi les priorités locales, pour s'assurer qu'il y a un succès au changement qu'on essaie d'apporter.
We all agree that when you're in control, it's better. When it's close to home for patients and family, it's better. Quality improvement is contributing to simplicity in the healthcare system, and it makes for a much more pleasant experience for us as patients and caregivers, and also for the doctors to have a rewarding experience and interaction.